Hi, it's Vicky here with a totally different project today. I will be creating a baby crib mobile using dice from the latest release by Simon Sesta. Simon has released many different dice that are great for cutting out felt, and they also give you the convenience of having all those little dots around the designs. For my project today, I will be using only one of those dice, and that's the little bear. So you can see that the set comes with its own magnetic piece of paper, so you don't lose anything. Now I am going to cut out the basic shape of the bear using felt, and I am going to use many different colors of felt as I will be creating four of those bears. So you can see how it cuts out all those little holes around, which are great when you are going to go ahead and stitch both of these pieces together. It also comes with different parts to embellish your bear, such as the nose, little heart, the eyes, the ears, which I am going to cut out using different colors. And here you can see that I have a nice pattern to follow along with my needle and my thread. And for my thread, I will be using a similar color as the bear. And I have tied a knot at the end of my thread, which I am hiding on the inside of those two pieces. And now I am going to go up and down all around the bear. Now, when you go up and down, you will see that you leave a gap between the stitches. I'm going to zoom in a bit so you can see what I mean. You can leave it as it is with all those gaps in between, but if you don't like that look, you can always go all around the design with your needle and thread and fill in the rest of the gaps, which is actually what I will be doing. So here is how it looks with all those gaps in between the stitching. And if you like that look, don't forget to fill in the bear before you finish off stitching. Now I am going to go back with my needle and thread and fill in all the gaps so you can see the other look. And really both look very cute. I just love the second one because it looks more finished, but it's more time consuming. So here is how it looks. I'm all the way to the beginning, and I am going to use my filler and make my bear look puffy. I am going to use a pencil, or you can use a bone folder or anything you have, just to push all that filling inside the little areas, like the bear's ears and the hands and everything. You don't need too much. I didn't want that to be super puffy. And once everything is there, I'm going to use my needle again and finish off stitching. And now that my bear is ready, it's time to stick all the embellishments. For that, I decided to go with my gel medium, and I found that it sticks felt to felt really great, but you can use any fabric glue that you have at home. The die set also cuts out little tiny eyes for the bear, but I decided to go with my enamel accents just because I can make them as big as I want. So I have that fine tip on my black enamel accents, and the truth is that it won't stay as it is at the moment. They are not going to be puffy and shiny, just because the felt is going to absorb all that, but they are going to still look nice and vibrant and very defined. I have followed the exact same steps and I have created four of those bears. So I have a pink, a yellow, and a green one. And you can see that I am using a contrasting color for my yellow bear. I'm using a thread, an orange thread, and maybe you like that look more. I just wanted to try it out, and I think I love how defined all those stitched edges are. Now I'm going to stick all those little embellishments again, just like I did with my blue bear, and I'm going to add the eyes and all the nose and everything. Now for the eyes, once they were dry, I did add a little bit of, just a dot of white gesso. You can also use white acrylic paint. And this really brings those bears to life. This die set also gives you small parts to cut out for creating a scarf for your bear, but I decided to go with a ribbon. I thought that was really quicker, so I'm just tying a double knot on the neck of each bear, and everyone has a nice little scarf. Now for the main mobile structure, I have used two sticks, wooden sticks. They are exactly 12 inches, each of them, and I'm going to color them by using acrylic paint. One, I'm going to color it blue, and the other is going to be orange. Instead of creating this cross structure, as I will be demonstrating, you can make your life easier and use a wooden embroidery ring. And you can just tie all those bears from there. And just like always, you can find a full list of all the supplies that I'm using today for this project just below the video in the description area, as well as on my blog. I am using my needle and I am going to thread some string at the top of the bears, and I'm going to tie a knot there so I can have a string to hang them from the wooden sticks. I'm going to repeat the same process for all four bears. And then I'm ready to assemble my mobile. I am using my ruler, and with a pencil I am going to mark where the center of those wooden sticks are. And since my sticks are 12 inches, I am marking at the 6th inch. This is where I am going to place one on top of the other to create my cross. Now to keep those two together, I am going to use just a dot of a glue that sticks wood on wood. This glue is going to keep them temporarily together until I secure both those sticks with my thread. Now my wooden sticks are nicely secured together, and I don't really care about that knot and the thread, because you can always cover it up by using a piece of ribbon that you can tie. You can just tie a bow, or you can do what I did with felt. I just used a circle die, and I cut out two felts out using that die. I found the center of one of those circles, and I'm going to use my crocodile to create a hole there. And this is where I am going to apply one of my eyelets. I am using a piece of ribbon that I am going to thread through that hole on my felt, and this is where I will be able to hang my baby mobile from. So at the back I am going to stick the other circle, and to do so I am using my hot glue gun. This is going to give a nice finish to my structure, since it's going to hide all that thread and the center of that cross. And now all that's left to do is to tie the bears on the structure. Now, the truth is that you don't really need to make them puffy. You can just look through your stash and see what dies you have, and all you have to do is to just cut out felt shapes and stick them on those threads. I am going to show you what I mean. I have cut out some stars out of dies that I already had, which I am just going to add a dot of hot glue. Stick them on the thread, and then I'm just going to cover everything up with one more shape. I am going to do that for a few of those stars, and I have also cut out clouds with another die, and I'm just going to do the exact same thing. So you can see that all those elements add even more details on my mobile, but at the same time they're not puffy, however they look very cute. And that was the project for today. I hope you had fun and got inspired. And if you did, don't forget to leave me a comment as well as give me thumbs up on my YouTube channel. If you need more inspiration, here are two more projects that I made a while back. Thank you all for watching.